students, a very good morning to all of you. Namaste, I'm Dr. Shruti Mishra. I'm assistant professor and the coordinator in the Department of Management Commerce, Faculty of Law and Governance in Jyothi Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Today we will going to discuss about something else definitely it is related to the mentorship only, but yeah, it will be unlike to the another two sessions we were having previously. In this session, we will definitely discuss about the upgradation of the students from the slow to average and average to advanced learners. Now, when we talk about the upgradation, it takes the lots of efforts from the situation we are right now, from the status we are having to the upgraded status. But nothing to worry about, we all are there to help you out, and definitely we will help you if any kind of problem you are having related to the academics as well as to the same extent related to the personal problems. Now, when we talk about the upgradation of the slow learners to the average learners, we talk about the ensuring the regularity of the students in the classes. Like if you are having the class at 9, you have to present at 9. Or before 5 minutes before than that, right? So be prepared for the lecture. In the previous day, you have to prepare your lectures, and then you come tomorrow for the next session. You are having the class for the slow students. I'm talking about, but it doesn't mean that the new it doesn't mean that the average students and the advanced students need not to do this, because this comes with the regular practice, and this is very much important for everyone. Now, the second point comes that the providing the extra classes if required in the related subject, you can say. If you are having any kind of problem related to the accountancy, or I'm talking about the basically the management students, but it's for all. You are from the different sections, different classes, different subjects, and different courses. So I'm talking about everyone. You are having a problem in the X subject, so you can talk to the faculty of that particular subject and you can ask for the help. And that faculty will definitely take your class related to that particular subject and will try to sort your problems out. Now the third point comes that the peer teaching. Have you heard about this term peer teaching? No. If not, then the peer means the person who is your friend, your colleague, or you can say the person who is working together, that comes in the peer groups, right? So when you are studying together, that means those students who are studying with you comes under the peer groups. So the senior students can definitely help you in this particular case if they know anything about that particular subject, and if they know about the tricks of that subject, they can tell you about those things. So need not to hitch about that you are not taking any kind of help from your seniors. You can take the help from the seniors and they will definitely help you out, right? Now the fourth point comes that the ensuring the continuous individualized monitoring by the mentor. It is very much important for all the mentors that they need to focus especially on all the students, but specifically to those students who are the slow learners or who are learning not in a very fast manner. So it's a responsibility of all the teachers or of all the mentors or of all the faculties that they need to take care of those students who are less responsive, or you can say who are very slow in learning the things. Now the fifth one is we are talking about the regular communication with the parents. We need to that a student need to keep in touch with the parents. A student need to keep in touch with their family, with their friends, with their loved ones, so that they can get affection. They can get the affection from their family as well. They need the thing of self-belongingness is very much important. And it comes with when you talk with the family, when you talk with the mother, your dad, your father, your sister, your brother, you are having your friends, your school friends, your college friends and the family people. So now, when we come to the regular, when we come to the ensuring the happiness of the student, that is a primary and focal responsibility of the faculties. Ensuring the completion of the minimum members of other activities and discipline wise. So it is very much important that there are the certain activities which has been grouped for the students in the different faculty wise. So they need to appear in those activities with each and every discipline they are having. Now, this is, we have discussed about the slow learners. Now we talk about the advanced, average to advanced learners. Those who are average learners and they need to take the effort to reach to the advanced learners status, they need to work on the certain parameters. The first one is ensuring the regularity of the student in the class. That is basically common, as I told you before. That is for all. That is common for all the students. Those who are advanced also need to keep this practice on the regular mode, that they need to come daily with on time basis. The next one is providing the extra classes and the regular communication. The students who are average learners need to practice about, it's not about the average learner, it's about everyone, that they need to make a practice about going to the library, read the books, because reading is the habit which if that has been inculcated in you, that can give you a not just knowledge, but yeah, that will definitely make you understand things in a better way, because learning is a main and the primary important part of any of the student's life, or you can say it's for, not for the students, it's for everyone. We always learn something by reading books, by getting the knowledge from the internet, from the social media, and we have lots of things that through that we can learn the things, right? So it's very much important for all these students. So basically this is an idea from the upgradation of the slow learners to the average, and the average learners to the advanced learners. So this is all for the day. I hope you like this video, and if you have any query related to this particular video, please do let me know in the next session, or I'll definitely try to sort these problems and we'll move to the next session as well. And thank you so much, students. Have a great day and stay safe.